Hey guys, so today's video is about me being organized and getting everything done. And I'll show you real quick. Anybody who's ever watched me knows that I have this book right here. It's got my sewing projects, it's got my fiber projects, it's got my crochet projects in it, it's got the blog, and it's got all my extra sheets that I need to write on for taking notes. And as you can see, it's quite thick. Not real happy. I mean, it works, okay, but I have to look here and there when I'm working on two or three projects. Let me get this out of the way. It's my birthday, so I'm having a little wine. It is what it is. Then I have, these are my little things from the other. Then I have to-do lists and things I need to get done, things I need to remember, projects, and projected costs. And I have all those. So then I have my barn journal, which I need to know what is being doctored. It's written down in there. When the births come into play, I write them down who had what, you know, birth weights and that. And this is my idea journal. So anything that I have that I come across, oh, this is a wonderful idea. I put it in there and then I wait about a couple of weeks. And if it still seems like a good idea, then I'll look into doing it. Now, that being said, I need, and I also have a calendar for appointments, okay? So I was looking for a way to get my week at a glance, get all of these things and these deadlines and these lists and these ideas into one page. So I came up with this little idea, and it's actually a cute little trick. I've been watching some planner videos, and I have a couple of pages back here on my devotional. I probably will use this one right here. Oops, let's see here if we can get that up a little bit. Sorry. It's just a sheet that I found on the internet, and yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and just use that as my devotional page. This is the page that we use right now for things that go on during the week that need to be mentioned in the blog. So, just the things that we've gotten done, the different projects that we're working on, that kind of stuff. So these two pages are already in use, and I'm just trying to get them organized. So what I've done is, yes, another binder, but it's, I think I actually am going to keep it pretty thin, so I'm happy with that. I am a Post-it girl, just so you know. I have more Post-its than most people. I have clear tabby ones, I have square ones, and this literally has a slide that you can slide on either way, and it slides over so that I can hook it on things. This is slid in here. It's not Post-its, but I'll show you how I use it and why it works. I have square ones on this side, then I've got lined ones. I have these squares, smaller squares. And trust me, I have no problem cutting these up to be the size that I want. These right here are actually little tabs, but I'll cut them up and use them long ways all the time. So, yeah, it is what it is. And then I've gotten highlighters and a package of colored pens. There was 8 different colors in one package, and it made it really look cute. That's just for cute factor, but you could do this. So I was looking at bullet journals, and this is what I came up with. I've got a weekly, a monthly, and an annual tab, and then an extra right here, which I've got some ideas for that. I think my devotional is going to go right there. So, I'm a Post-it girl, and I love to have Post-it, and I will show you that Mike has no Post-its around it now. They're all in here, yay! We have, RJ got his computer back, so it doesn't have any Post-its on it yet, so. But the desktop doesn't have one on it, any on it yet either. So, all right, so what I was going to show you, this cute little trick, is I don't have time every week or every month. I was looking at bullet journaling, and they always draw a new calendar. And they'll have hand-drawn monthly calendars, and they'll have hand-drawn weekly calendars, and they'll have hand-drawn. I don't have time for that. So what I did was I came up with my own little thing. These are called transfer sheets, and I'm going to show you what it is. Mine has sticky notes on it. It is those things that you use on an overhead projector. I know you know what I'm talking about. Well, the good thing about these, if you've ever worked with them, you know they're staticky. So, my weekly page is right here. I cut apart, this is any emails I have to take care of, any calls I have to take care of that week. I have tasks and videos that, that we have to get done. And this just says this week. So this is going to be my main page. But if I write on this, then I have to draw it all over again next week. So what I've done is I took this little lovely thing and I put it down, and all my post-it notes become removable. Now, let me show you something else. You don't have to have post-it notes because this is clingy. I mean, it's staticky, and it's staticky by nature. I mean, that's just the way it is. This just says note, and it is the top part of this right here. Okay, so this part up here, I just cut it off. There's no post-it. It's not sticky. It's one of those refrigerator magnet things. And I use the other two parts right there. So I had this one left over, and I put on it's some things, and I've already got it done. I ordered the parts for the computer and got checked the refund, and it's clearing the bank today. So these things will be done, and when I'm done with them, the wonderful thing, this is done. So guess what? It goes away and gets thrown in the trash. I literally have stacks and stacks of post-its, and post-its are really cute. You can get some really cute ones. They're not very expensive. You can get them at Dollar Tree. You can get them anywhere. So post-its of all shapes and sizes are great. This one I have some teacher's packs I've got to do. I've got to clean up the barn, fix the Wi-Fi. And these right here, these little tabs that I told you, these are the perfect size just to put right on the day. This is my Target cleaning area. I have one of those every week. Let's see here. This is my menu one. Now I made the page. This is the actual page, okay? And it says menu, ingredients, and then it's got a little part for have or need. And I was gonna write, what I have, but I don't want to have to rewrite it. And this is gonna be cute for every week, but I'm not gonna redraw this every week. So I put a template over it, a little thing. And when I actually pick these up, this goes with it. If you look, if I don't split it to show you guys, it just picks it up by itself. So I don't have to, I just pick up this plastic piece and it brings that page with it. So I just stuck a big sticky note on it and said shopping list, and that's probably the way I'll do it. But I'm not gonna go redraw it. This is my chores one that I came up with, and every day I do different ones. And again, this has a plastic cover over it, and look, it just picks up that piece of paper on the back. So when I go to flip the page, it just flips with it. But I've got all my things. This one actually goes someplace else. I have a meeting coming up, and that was my OHCE meeting that I need to put on a day. It's next week though. But I've got Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. And for those of you that don't know, I do a one chore a day kind of thing. Saturday I do general pickup of the whole house. Sunday has been added for my journal page. I just do my one page, collect all the information from each page, put it on one page, and I'm done. Which just means I pull these post-it notes off and write post-it notes and stick them on there. That's all my journal page is write post-it notes and stick them on there from the other pages. So, Mondays I dust, Tuesday I do the kitchen, Wednesday I vacuum, Thursday I do the bathroom, and Friday I declutter. In the summer, I clean waters on Friday, mow the yard on Wednesday, and clean the barn on Monday. Then I have this little post-it right here, which is, I call it my traveling post-it. It's got dishes, trash, cat box, laundry, and floors. And I do that. I spot, sweep, and mop the floors every day, and then I go through and vacuum the whole house, when it needs it. This is my payday one. Down here I've got cheese. So garden will, if there's something that I have to address with those, I will. And I'm actually thinking about cutting them down smaller so that they're just kind of not so big. But here's the thing, guys, when these get sticky or unsticky, just throw them away and rewrite another one. I've got a ton of post-its. And look, when you pick it up, there goes the page. So then I've got my monthly, and I have an extra one of these because I thought I was going to put something else back here, and I haven't done it yet. So any other pages that I come up with will be right there. And then The monthly right here is, and this sounds silly, that's just my big butterfly clip. I like it, so it stays. I decided I'm going to do the month. This, again, is just one of those tabs. And I just pull it up, put another month. I can throw it away, find something cute. You can actually buy post-it notes with months on it if I wanted to. I don't care. I've got enough. I don't care. I cut some of these. Oh, I'm sorry. I cut some of these up just to have them for stuff. And then I don't write every date. Okay, and I've got some down here that are just blank. Now, what I do is I put the first here, or whatever day it starts on, you know, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and I might put those across here. I've thought about it, writing them in. I just haven't done it. And then I write the number of the date, like today was my birthday, okay, and this is Tuesday the 6th month on how it falls for February. So I just put my number of birthday, and see the 6 down at the bottom? That's the date. So I know Tuesday is the 6th, put it where it goes, and I've got all of my stuff in here. Here's Valentine's Day, Farmers Market Conference, and then I put one for the end of the month. And I just look up anytime that I have one that I need. I mean, I can do the math. I know that sounds silly, but if it was to say the 20th, well, I've already got something on here for the 14th. And even if I didn't have something for the 22nd, I can count it. That's the 20th and put it on there. So, and because our minds work, we know Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Just saying. And again, when you pick it up, that just goes right away. I have my appointment for the farm in here. I do have, now this appointment thing is got phone numbers and stuff on it, so I'm not going to show you when people make appointments. I write them in there. And this is just one that I tore apart because I didn't like all the other junk with it. I just need calendar pages. I have the monthly payments, and I'm going to start working on a budget here. And again, we'll see. And I may do a whole sheet for those because this is just printed off of the computer. Don't know yet. So that's the more of the calendar. This is the annual, and this is what I came up with for it. This has got the farm schedule. And this is divided into two sections, and it literally goes January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. And it's got four little lines on each one. Week 1, week 2, week 3, week 4. Just saying. So these are already in order. We've got stuff. The market conference always takes place in February, the third week of February. I've got some school stuff that is put in here that's just on this for this year, and I'll take it off when we're done. Coggins always comes due on all the horses in April along with their vaccinations. Our farm event is the first weekend in April always. Plant Pizza Tower, fireflies and stargazing. These happen in these weeks, kind of steady. And then if we decide to move them around, I just pick up the post-it, peel it off, and put it in a new spot. So I've got haying season. Lee starts his vacation that week, so that's when our haying season will start this year. Harvest the tower, close for the season. So this is the farm stuff. And I have a couple of extras down here and some notes that I can leave. And again, when I pick this up, all I have to do is grab the piece of plastic. I've got the post-it notes and it stays. So they're reusable without me having to rewrite on them. I love my post-it notes. This is the sheep schedule here. We've got our medications down here that we're using this time. Any notes that I need. This is just a blank one that I didn't need. I slapped it on the notes. But we've got everything from the warming, to lambing season, shearing, vaccinations, when the lambing season ends, when the fall lambing starts, when we start our first round of breeding, when we start our second round of breeding, and when breeding ends. So, and anything else that we'd have to do in between here. Shearing is on here for the fall. Shearing is on here for the spring. And again, pick up the little transfer sheet and my page, my stickers, everything go with me. It really, it makes it nice. Now, if you're using copy paper, I don't know how, well, it does stick to it, and I'll show you how I know this. And that is because when I pick up this one here and go like this, see, it sticks to it, but I don't know how well it will do. So, and this is just our blog and social tracker that I do each year. I'm going to start doing, I do it once a month, but it's got the whole year on the page, so. Anyway, so this is what I've come up with, and I like it because it literally, I'm going to look at these post-it notes once a day. Oops, sorry. I mean, once a week, I'll come in on Sunday. I will look at my post-it notes. I will take off anything that I don't need. Migrate what I need to wherever I need it. Either these will be done or not. Cross them off. Pull this off when I get done with the videos. If I get done with all these videos that I need to address or questions that I need to address in videos, I'll pull this off and then I'll start with my new post-it with whatever's left from this one. So yeah, it's going to use post-its, but if you guys ever saw the number of post-its I have, you would understand. And there's so many cute post-its. So my only expense in this will be post-its that you can pick up at Dollar Tree. And there's literally a ton of them. And I like my post-its anyway, so why not utilize them? When I quit working, I didn't use them as much. This one right here, I'm going to probably use these little flapper kinds right here and just put a meal on there. Oops, and I'm knocking some off. This is what they call a dashboard. I'll give you a hint. If your post-it notes don't stick or the last one doesn't really want to stick, you take a glue stick, and this one isn't sticking because it's kind of, I have this in the way to push it down real good. But if it doesn't want to stick, you can run glue stick across there, and trust me, it'll hold it down. So, yeah, just saying. But I do get a lot of these, and I love my little tabs and my things. These I use more as like marks for to highlight stuff. I'll actually put it over something on, let me grab this. This is one that I have reused several times. Say I want to highlight this because I know it's on deadline. I literally put it over it to highlight it so that I know it needs to be taken care of. So I use these more as highlighters than I do as post-its. So, and yes, I have a ton of these things too. And they will highlight even on dark colors. So don't be fooled that you can't use them on certain ones or whatever. So, anyway. Alright, this is not the best video. I'm going to get off of here. But I did want to show you that if you are into planning, these little transfer sheets make bullet journaling super easy because you make one sheet and then you get to play with stickers and post-its and all that stuff on the front and then clean it off and start all over. So, yeah. I kind of like it. It's simple, sweet, to the point, and everything I do has, you know, and the ones that I would need like weekly are right here. So I get up in the morning, check and see my chores, make sure they're done, do my schedule, menu, get anything out that I would need out of the freezer, and then flip this one back right here and have all my stuff right here on the front page. So super happy with it. We'll see how it evolves. And who knows, I might find another planner sometime else, but for now I'm going to keep doing this. The blog one, I might put this, just put a template over it and see. I have another one that I use that's brainstorming ideas, so I might put those templates over these and see. My devotional, I won't. I remember the Bible scriptures better when I write them, so I will be writing my scriptures in here still. So, yeah. Anyway, alright, I'm going to get off here and get this uploaded and go to bed, and you can now see my little planner, and these transfer ideas are awesome, awesome, awesome. They just make everything reusable, and I don't have to redo everything all the time. So, have a good one, and I will talk at y'all later.